Welcome back, everyone. Here, Stemus, bringing you some more of our marching of the hordes. We are currently, I guess, sieging down Yarkand, and we will soon be moving on their capital. It looks like they've just sieged back Taraz. No big deal. I was hoping that they might go into my land, but they're probably just gonna siege back all of their land. Probably best thing for me to do right now is just move this guy. And do we want a leader right now? Yeah, I should have a leader. No, I should have another leader. I should get... I don't want to spend more than that. Those are some pretty terrible rolls. Although I only have 14 army tradition, so that's actually not terrible considering, but I was really hoping for a little bit better there. But we'll move Sufyan Borachinois into Kotchkor. Oh man, yeah. So that means there that now Lithuania is under a personal union with Poland. And I don't think that ever doesn't happen in these single player games. Okay, so we got province. Okay. Nope. So let's just kill your... And what time are you leaving? 5th, 15th. Okay. Can we scare... Oh, we can kill you anyway. No big deal. Okay, we'll just sit on your capital. That sounds like a good idea. Yep. They're dead, only lost 96 men. No worries. And your capital, all it is just a capital fort, so... I mean, we just gotta sit here and wait. Do we have any siege value on this guy? No. They're actually... They're identical number of pips, it's just... Right now in the game, you want shock much more than you want fire. Like, fire is almost worthless. Let you move out, and we'll just take back the province. Get some loot out of it. Sit in the highlands. I mean, the highlands is a great place. Oh, we breached the walls here. So the breach wall, basically what that means is, you can see the siege status. Normally the walls provide a fixed modifier, like in this case, they negate your chance to take the fort by a certain percentage. But when you breach the walls, then you overcome that modifier, so it speeds up siege speed immensely, and it is wonderful. Okay, so now let's go... Oh, where are you going? You are going into... Yeah, I might as well just go to Talas. Golden Horde declared war on Kazan as well. Golden Kazan, you're in trouble. Golden Horde, are you also at war with the Timurids? Yeah, but you're counting on the Timurids not getting up there. Do they have military access at all? No. Oh man, I can give you military access, man. It's not a big deal for me. Declared. Okay. I mean, we can play this game all day, my friend. I can just move around. I mean, once I got your capital, that's pretty much GG. We'll wait until you're in the... Wait until you're in the plains. That's not a big deal. Wait until you're in the plains and go for you. Let's create a template right now. No, it's not worth it. So let's... What's my autonomy? Floor of 25%. I think this 50% means, yeah, the tribes own it. So when you give a province away, I guess, I'm not sure if it's the same for Western or Eastern or whatever nations that have different kinds of estates, but for those other countries, or for this country in particular, you gain 25% autonomy in provinces that you assign to your estates. So let's train up some Eastern Swarm Cavalry. Oh yeah, somewhere I want it. There. Eastern Swarm Cavalry, and we can do 2. Yeah, doesn't hurt. We're still 4 away from our force limit, and that's about where we want to be. And our force limit, of course, is going to get much bigger when we take over this a huge chunk out of Yarkand. Let's see, how much can we take? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How much extension is that? I mean, why not? That's Chagatai there. I mean, yeah, 81% overextension. Oh, happy sovereign value. Okay, never mind. So, yeah, if we can split them in half like that, that is ideal. Can we make you a vassal? Can we take less land? Don't really want to make you... Why is that 100... Oh, it's 135 because that's the cost of Uzbek. Yeah. So yeah, we'll just take all your provinces. And we're gonna split you right down the middle of the... Right down the middle of the wasteland, so you won't be able to actually do anything effective with your troops. It's gonna make you easier to take down later. Humiliate would be good. Let's take a look at the war score. Yeah, let's... Do I need Uskend? No. It never hurts to have a little bit of border gore to ruin his country. Then Choi, we don't really want that. We definitely want to humiliate, and we want all your money, some of your money. Okay. So now we're just going to wait for him to get in planes. After we've taken his capital, we're going to just go move on and destroy his army. Going to be a good time. And we're at 35%. I mean, that means... Oh, we can be nice converted. Might as well. Shamanist. Oh, you're not happy, but we will probably have converted it by then. Oh, they got that. We got Kakor. Or Kachor. Or Kachkor, I don't know. 49%. Oh, come on. Two chances. Flip a coin. Aw, oh, man, you serious? Okay. Yeah, we'll just sit in the mountains, we'll wait for you to tire yourself out, sieging back. Oh. So I gotta be careful that he doesn't go and kill my own troops. Come on, flip a coin. Oh, okay. See, you're now moving into our land, because... Step Nomads, you're gonna defend there. It's gonna be wonderful. What is your composition? Oh, ours is much better. Do I want piety? Or do I want to? I want money. Piety. What does piety give us? Gives us more money. Gives us more manpower. Gives us better technology cost. It gives us more morale, better fort defense, and better missionary strength. Yeah, I think I'll lose the piety to begin with, and then later on, I can probably get it back. I mean, because I'm just basically fighting Sunni neighbors, my piety is going to go down. I think Syncretic faiths count as, I think he counts as Sunni, so I think it's still a crime against Allah. And I just took your capital. I can wait there. Are you the good guy? Yeah, you're the terrible guy. Okay. Actually, let's wait until I can get some more cavalry together, because I've got 4 here. 4 here. If I can just swap out the cavalry. Yeah, we'll let you sit there for a little bit. My cavalry's gonna finish here soon. What do you want? No, I'm not gonna. I have my own ideas for what I want. Unless your ideas coincide with mine. And they do not. Throw in some more cash there. Yeah. It's unfortunate that I can't. I mean, I could do that. No, I can't do that, because that changes the war score across. So, I won't. Take in the fort. Alright, you have attrition because it's winter. You also have attrition because it's winter. You're never going to take the, you're never going to take the city. So let's move these guys down cautiously. I don't know how aggressive the AI is for stack wiping little units. And we will look for your guys. There. Do they actually have a fire value? I'd have to go check here. They do, actually. So fire actually isn't terrible. But I think our cavalry shock is just gonna be so much better that we don't even need to worry about it. So we're just gonna move our infantry over there. We're probably gonna disband them. Have maybe this worse army go hunt down this little itty bitty 1,000 stack there. Just instantly squish it because we're 10 times bigger than he is. And we'll go back to ruining his day. Then we can move you down, because you're going to be engaged in a battle. No, don't care. Okay, we're going to move you down as well, join you up with the rest of the army. And then... Oh, there we go, we engaged. Yeah, we're just completely smashing them. It's not even fair. 2,600 to over almost 7,000. No, that's not even fair. Okay, we're gonna move there because you're blocked. We're gonna move you there. You are going to join this army, and you're gonna join this army because you're closer. You're gonna join this army because you're right there. And that's going to get, I don't know, maybe not instantly squished because now it's down to 7,000 strong rather than 10,000 strong, but yeah, it's going to be pretty much a cakewalk. So I'm going to move you, where are you going to go? You're probably going to go there. And I'm going to move you there. So we're just going to hunt you down. You're just infantry, but that should be fine for now. You're not even... Well, I guess it's good to have my fire leader in charge of pure infantry stuff. You're fighting into... instantly wiped. So that is 4,000 killed for a little over 300. I'll take that any day. So you will definitely capitulate to my demands. So we're just going to take that. Fine. Let's take a look at the diplomatic view. So, as we can see, I haven't cored these provinces yet, and a really cool mechanic in this patch is that we can raise provinces. So, I mean, this province isn't that great, so we only get 25 military points out of it, because we're probably only going to raise it by one military pip here. So we do that, we get some horde lunity, we get some loot, and some points, which is awesome. Basically, evens out. We're gonna raise this guy here. We get 25 each because each of them goes down by one. This guy here, we get just 25 as well. Increase it all by one. Not bad. And we just keep it up. And unfortunately, I mean, we got back at a cost in admin that we spent, or not in military that we spent to roll the two generals. And there we go, we're going to make these cores, and they're even cheaper now because I lowered the development, so that's also pretty sweet. We're going to be making all those. those cores anymore. No. Free advisor slot. Let's do... We have yearly inflation reduction. We don't have any gold mines, I don't think. Production efficiency. Do we have any yearly inflation? No, we don't have any yearly inflation. So let's grab production efficiency, because we can. Let's grab Diplo Rep, because that's always good to have. And land maintenance modifier, yeah, it's always nicer to pay a little bit less. And then we can lower our army maintenance, because we're at peace, for a little bit at least. Are you still allied with Kazan? You are. Chagatai, you're still at war with the Oriat. Oriat, who are you allied with? Korchin, that's not too bad. You're currently winning against Chagatai. Or is that worth? Okay. So, can I... Let's just take a look at how... A history ledger. Let's see how scary the Oriat Horde is right now. Scroll down. Orissa... Oriat. Oh man, we could definitely take them. And let's see, Mongolia. Okay, so they add a bit more to it. And then Korchin? Korchin's got nothing at all. Okay. So, I might be able to just throw you. Can I offer you an alliance? Which provinces do we... I mean, I'll give them up. Oriat and Mongolia. Okay. Let's go here. Go to diplomacy. Go here. We can just... Oh, come on. There we go. We'll just remove Oriat. Remove that. Remove Mongolia. And Bob's your uncle. I think we can form an alliance. 8 provinces. What else? Oh. My course. Okay. Well, let's just remove these here. How about now? I mean, it'd be good for you. Well, we did the mission. No guy. Urshar. Where's Urshar? Urshar's right there. Yeah, I think so. How many troops do you have still? You don't got any occupations there. Anything going on for you there? The ledger. Does Chagatai actually have anything going for them? No. Okay. Never mind. We're not helping Chagatai. Kazan's done. I can offer you military access, man. I mean, you could walk through my lands. You don't want it, and I don't really know why. Oh, Novgorod, can we? Oh, no. My navy strength. I'm landlocked, man. Dude, seriously, there's no way for me to get a navy. You need to come off that bullshit. We'll just wait and see how this... Do we need to? I mean, we can just bait them into our lands and then smash them. Chagatai. I mean, you're getting pretty wrecked. Do I want to deal with that? I don't want to deal with that, but... For you, I can. Okay. For you, I can. Okay. Well, in the next episode, we'll see if Chagatai calls us to war, and we get to deal with the Oread Horde. Have a good one, guys. See you next time.